Hey. So it's Gary's, it's Tori's graduation.
Tori's fifth grade graduation.
Tori's fifth grade, not high school. Not from medical school, but fifth grade graduation. Started a new regimen, which
well,
is going to
really... Well, I'm starting tomorrow morning.
Starts tomorrow morning. There's going to be a lot less of her starting soon.
We hope.
In any case... Here's the graduation girl. Man, she does look like she's graduating from high school, doesn't she?
God help
you
us.
You clowns are growing too quickly, you know that?
Mm-hmm. Well,
okay.
My taste.
Oh, well, we're out of here. Hey, where is this place?
It's the Hyatt Regency Intercontinental Airport.
It's the Lowett Regency. No, Hyatt Regency. Right next to the airport.
Next to the airplane. Yeah.
We got the pastel thing going tonight. Everybody's all kind of pastel-y. And they're pastel-y, they didn't make it quite to Patty. All right, never mind. Never mind. Oh, and here we are. Look at this place. Very cool. Look at the garden back there. Graduates.
He's here.
I have the only fourth grade on you. Oh,
thank
you.
I was going to wait
until
they had
Tori C. Say hello. That's Tori C.
I was going to wait until actually they had everything up to tape it.
Oh, okay.
If the brightness setting is right on this.
No, brightness setting's too low.
That's what I thought.
Will
we fix it?
That was a good joke. Yes, hold on.
There's Tori. Tori's in.
And Anthony.
Not awesome teacher. Oh, about 14 pictures here. Let's see. And then most of them are over here, actually. There's my snorkel.
Hey, I love them, won't you? Give me a
And then most of Tori's pictures are this.
We're sitting at this place.
There you go.
Give me some love.
Oh. Yeah. Okay, now you can pose.
This is my graduation. It's somewhat small compared to last year's, but still.
Small graduation for a small person.
Small graduation for a small
person.
Hi. Ooh, look at this. Our beams counteract each other.
pleasure and a lot of pride to present to you all the 5th and 6th grade graduating class of the Christian School of Cleveland. We learned to believe in ourselves and know we were capable of greatness. Ms. Robinson visionally helped us learn important lessons too. There were times when the work was hard, but we knew God would not give us anything we couldn't handle. Yet, sometimes I thought he mistrusted us an awful lot. And Ms. Walker, we will remember you for the time you fell off your chair. No, not really. Instead, we will remember you from the energy and enthusiasm you brought to PE. We love all of our teachers, the CSK teachers, we will see you in movies one day because you're a great actress. Brittany, I will remember you by your kindness. You were a great addition to our class. Travis, you kept the class interesting with your fun stories and your individuality. Tori B, I will always remember you by your high standards and your laugh. And Alex, I will smile because you're my brother and I.
The students for a short time this evening. And I say that because he truly had virtually no notice and yet is here tonight prepared to speak to these children. And we're grateful to have Dr. Randy Bell here with us to do that tonight. I will tell you that Dr. Bell is one of the founders of CSK, and he was on the very first school board of CSK and served there for a total of 12 years.
I want to thank you for the opportunity to be able to speak to you tonight. Your teachers and your family are very happy and proud of your accomplishments in the elementary school at the Christian School of Kingwood. During the first few years, you have learned to read, write, and spell, along with much of how Jesus wants you to live in this world. I assume you learned how to spell and all that stuff. You learned that? Okay. You will have many more years of education and life experiences to grow and enjoy, beginning next year as you begin middle school. I would like to take a few minutes to remind you of four principles as you continue out through the years of your growth and development. It only take about an hour and a half, so it's going to be fine.
Victoria Elaine Brooks was born in Houston, Texas on April 14, 1993. She's the daughter of Geraldine and Robert Brooks and is a sister of Alexandra Brooks. Tori has attended CSK since she began her school career in preschool. This year she graduates from the 5th grade. She is 11 years old. Victoria Brooks, whom we all frequently call Tori B, is a lovely, bright young lady. It has been a great privilege to know her. When you meet Tori B for the first time, you are usually struck by her quiet self-confidence and the look in her eyes, which is direct, intelligent, and inquisitive. I met Tori when she came to kindergarten. I knew she was an unusual sort of girl when she asked for books about snakes. She not only wanted to read about snakes, she wanted to keep snakes for pets. She still does. She shared her bubbly enthusiasm for snakes, and even though I am not a snake lover, her enthusiasm was contagious. Soon I found myself looking for any book in the library that even mentioned books, snakes in passing, just so I could share them with her and enjoy her enthusiasm. She is one of those people who, although is quiet in nature, is not shy about sharing her enjoyment of life. Today, when asked what she likes to do with her free time, she will say, "I absolutely love to read books. I love writing poetry, and I love creating poetry." Tori is a multi-talented individual, and she's won several outstanding awards. She is most proud of winning 3rd place in the Houston Chronicle Spelling Bee this year. She has also won 1st place in the CSK Rodeo Art this year, and she has won 1st place in the CSK Science Fair this year. She has received a superior ranking in math at the academic meet, a contest in which she competed against many students from other Christian schools. She has also won numerous awards at CSK over her years there. Tori's interests include reading, poetry, music, soccer, and last but most important to Tori, designing buildings and clothes. She enjoys creating things, especially when it includes the challenge that comes from using math and her own artistic style to create something beautiful. There's no rule that says a building can't be beautiful, she says. She plans to attend Rice University, become a civil engineer and an architect, and she would like to be a clothes designer too. In the future, Tori would like to design churches where people can worship. She hopes someday to travel to Spain, England, Italy, and especially the city of Venice. When Tori becomes an architect, a dream of hers is to be involved in helping restore the city of Venice. Tori says she has learned in her years at CSK to be independent, to do her best, to set her goals, and to appreciate herself. When asked to describe some of her favorite CSK memories, Tori said there were so many it was hard to pick just one. But the most recent was the moment she walked into the fifth and sixth grade classroom and saw a huge poster written by her classmates and other students congratulating her on her achievement in the Houston Spelling Bee. The funniest moment she recalls is the time she was challenged to do a high kick in PE. With the greatest of ease and confidence, she kicked so high with one leg that the other leg came out from under her and she landed flat on the floor. Tori, as you go out into the world to follow your dreams, may God's word be a lamp to your feet and a light to your path. Psalms 119:105. To you, Tori, and to all CSK graduates, may the Lord watch over you, your comings and goings, both now and forevermore. Psalms 128.
We haven't seen my office. Here it is. Started about a month ago. Another recital. Late May, 2004. Thank you. Tori's soccer party. What's that going on there, Alex?
Don't let the dogs out.
Oh, okay. Well, we're having French drains put in our backyard. There's Mom over there. Trimming down day by day, killing weeds tonight. And look at this trench. These French drains supposedly will pull up all the water, which has been pooling here every time that it rains. I'm sorry, what?
Or at least make it less bad.
Make it less bad, that's right. Less bad is better than
I climbed it!
Oh, okay. Funky chunky.
I'm going to climb it. Daddy, I'm going to climb it. Looky. And I wonder what would happen if I took a bath in here.
You would get dirty? Stay tuned. You'll probably see that cleared out by the next time.
Dad, don't turn off! Don't turn off!
Come here, look at this.
So what's up with the leaves?
Well, I don't know. They weren't like this a couple days ago, and look at that one.
They're very weird. They've got the mumps.
Yeah. Anyway, but see how the problem is? This one keeps swinging over to grow into the light because of this oak tree.
Stay away from the light.
Well, the problem is it's causing this one to grow on crooked, so we either got to take this out or take that out. And wouldn't you rather leave this one?
Oh, okay.
Don't you think?
Okay. Let's see if we can show her. There she is. That's the mama bird. Here's her lips set about the three baby mockingbirds that we have in here.
Yeah.
And here they are. We've been feeding them a little bit. I think they're starting to squawk for a little more food. But they were flat. They were on the floor out there. And it was pretty obvious that a cat comes across here every now and then was going to get them. So we put them in here and we're feeding them dog food with egg yolk. And looks like they're going to be, she's pretty upset about the whole thing right out there. Let's see if we can get a little bit of a close-up from her. She's been squawking at us a lot. Do a little bit of dive bombing too.
To me?
Yes, to you. That's right, kid. Alex has prepared a dinner of sorts for her. She's not feeling very good. She's got a headache and a leg ache. But look at this. Wow, we have strawberries with sugar on them. And we're dipping in what? What is that? Cool Whip? I think she's feeling a little better. Are you feeling better, Rockhead? Okay, good job. And what do you think of that? Huh? Yeah, okay.
Thanks, because I definitely look my best right now.
That's how you know impending teenagerdom is coming. Suddenly all the worried about, she's suddenly worried about how she looks, but not worried enough to actually do anything about it. See, that's how you know she's...
that was...
I don't take kindly to being woken up at 8 o'clock in the morning in the summer.
Oh, your life is so hard. How do you stand it?
That's my children 4 hours usual earlier than she wakes up.
I was going to say, I've lost track of how many birds I've caught.
See, here's the bird.
I am the queen bird catcher.
Yeah, this one's a little tiny chimney swift.
I heard its wings flapping.
Yeah, Lexi heard it, so Mommy reached in and caught it.
I heard its wings.
I'm getting better. It took me about 5 seconds this time. But she's scared, so we're going to let her go now.
You can touch her if you want.
Tweet, tweet, says hi.
Okay, we're going to go let her go.
All right, what's going on here?
Well, Dally thought she could steal my pilly with impunity. So we've been wrestling for the better part of 20 minutes here. Until she gives in and says uncle so I can go to bed after she admits that I'm the best and she's the worst. And she's about to get a wet willy if she doesn't.
Oh, I want to see the wet willy.
Let's see, we got to put one arm around. She's trying to bite me. For a minute. Look, look, it's, look, 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 look. It's the claw! Why don't you just admit that I don't do it with a sprained wrist. Why don't you just admit that I've won so we can all go to bed? And I can stop squishing you like a little big bug.
Just I got her ear! I got her ear! She got wet willy!
Stop, stop, stop! I'm trying to say something, but I can't!
Okay,
yeah.
Okay. I did have to pop all her toes earlier to retrieve my pilly from her clutches.
Okay! Uncle! Jeez.
You didn't? You said I'm cool. You didn't say uncle.
I said uncle.
And what does uncle mean?
Uncle means...
Mom the
you
best.
You weigh more.
Mom's the best. Say mom's the best. Tori's the worst.
Tori's the worst.
Mom won.
Mom won.
Tori's a loser.
Tori's a loser.
I'm going to leave my mom's pilly alone.
Leave my mom's pilly alone.
Mom rules and Tori drools. What a lot of noise. Hey, once again, it's July 4th, this time in the year 2004, and we're heading to where we head every time. Look at these. Hey, look at these canned crickets here. How do you like our new car? Well, maybe not our new car. It's our temporary car because this woman got bashed.
We're not having a good summer.
It's ugly.
Yeah, today. Let's see. What is today? Today's July 4th.
Well, exactly 1 month
woken
ago
at
on
4
June 4th, I got clobbered
it's
by
ugly,
the teenager.
It's ugly, stupid, idiotic, and
last month on the 4th, we had arson at the office.
Arson at the office, which we're still in, by the way. Okay, let's... Well, here we are. It's the very end of July in the year 2004.
Last day of July, in fact.
And we're taking Beth out for a walk.
Snake in the grass.
Yeah, she's a snake in the grass. We can sort of get an idea of her size.
Alex, that's not even funny. You're gonna step on her tail. Please. You're doing that, okay? Right. What?
It's a warm one, of course. End of July in Texas.
Now it's gonna
and Beth's
be
getting pretty big.
School's gonna start.
I think Beth is longer than you are, Tori.
Yep.
Go ahead and pick her up real quick. Maybe she'll smile for the camera.
Snap.
Yep, pretty far cry from when we first got her over here. But still not a monster, and that's good. All right, say bye. We're going to be going to Wimberley on Monday.
best boy in the whole world. Yes, I am. Yes, I am. He's watching Tori.
That's who Boots is watching.
He's your door open.
Yes, he is. He doesn't know who to watch now. Now Lex came in.
That's cool, Lexi. Chill, you chill, you're going with your mouth closed.
Wimberley, we're taking these goofballs to Goofball Hotel. And yeah, well, so there. All right, here's the office. I think we got a little bit of, although we haven't seen it since it's changed. Financial services. Oh, plastic glass. See, Mom had a hand in this. Ooh. About to leave.
Do you have any money for me? Before you leave, money, money, money.
Money, money, money.
Hey, what's going on?
I'm having a vicious fight with the puzzle box, but I think I won it.
Rotten, stinking puzzle boxes. Beautiful out there. Okay. We've been here for a few hours. Here. Here's Friggles McSugar. Supposedly, Auntie Denise is joining us tomorrow, along with a few of our cousins. Oh, there it is. What's going on in here?
Hello.
Huh? Ooh, we know what's going on.
I'm sorry, I don't know what that
meant. I need you to open up the door for me, please. Would you open
okay.
up the door?
Okay.
Steaks and burgers. I got some burgers. Here.
I don't think I can
Hey, here's the other foot. Where'd that come from?
You're more than coffee.
Hey! You've got a little sparkly. Oh, he caught me. Don't put that on the internet, whatever he did.
Hey!
Okay, two more. Come on. This time we'll actually count with a number.
All right, so it's pretty easy going night here. Look at this. What's going on, Tori's? Tori's getting rubbies. What's going on down there?
Lexi's getting her head rubbed by her dad.
Oh, yeah, yeah. See, look, I'm rubbing Alex's head like that, and she's just kind of passing out. But really, that's all we're doing here tonight. Look at this really lovely place here. Up and over. We just had steak and burgers there right now, and it was pretty tasty. And there's that, and there's... And yeah, back to the junk box. Pretty easy going night here. First night away. What is today? Today's the 2nd or 3rd of August? 2nd of August, 2004, folks.
The 2nd.
Say goodnight.
Yes.
Well, here's the house. differently. They think it's hot too. I guess we should turn around. I don't think they can let us come any closer.
I was afraid to get
right
bit,
here.
So I let him go. Yeah.
What am I doing here?
well, he's a good size. I mean, if you're catching fish like this. So, I thought he was neat. But I probably had to let him go so he doesn't die of fright.
Little House on the Prairie. Ba-ba-ba-da. And down we go. We've got the combined mental might of...
You ready?
Of what?
Oh, I guess you guys would just be at work here, and that's fine. All right.
Must find Greenpeace.
You're probably going to be up in the northeast somewhere. Oops.
Let's see.
It's all right. It's all right.
Sorry.
Hey, Mom is making avocado stuff. Denise went out and got crazy and purchased the whole store.
Food, glorious food.
She bought the whole store, and we're loving that. And Jerry's making avocado.
Jerry's...
guacamole, right?
Well, Denise is making guacamole. I'm just peeling the avocado.
Okay, so we're going to have these chips with that. That's mixed in, I guess, that Tom tomato. And there, rolled gold and... Easy. Twist. Meanwhile, the brain trust is over here trying to get it together, trying to get it going. It's got to be done before you leave, guys.
Oh, no way.
Mama, I found a piece to your thingy.
And there's a beautiful Wimberley.
Relax.
More on the puzzle. Tori's looking for any tasty pieces.
Wait.
Hey, Tori, Rachel, stand up.
Oh, you're just making fun of Tori's lack of
pies. That's not nice.
Oh, Tori knows she's, vertically challenged.
Such emotion.
Thank you.
Have you seen
yeah,
the
mind
stuff
you how you are horizontally challenged?
Okay.
You just called your father horizontally
no,
challenged.
I'm not challenged. I make it all the way through, no problem.
I can't believe you said that.
That's a good comeback, though. Good comeback.
Anyway, yeah,
more? What is it? 3 of August, right?
Pardon?
It's August 3rd, right?
Yes.
Okay. Big day, bankering down the corner.
This means I love you.
This means the devil loves.
No, just kidding. again. This means Jurassic Park.
That's for sure, man.
What's that?
All right, now we've been completed here.
I'm leaving Thursday to go to San Antonio.
What's up, dude? Hey,
oh,
get
you got
your
a bad case of hat
let's
hair,
your
man.
Cheers.
What?
You wanna... Yeah, let's hear your guitar. Come on.
All right. Come on. Let me play some guitar.
So I'm sure by Sunday or Thursday night late, I'll get there, but not
to me,
it'll be probably
on Wednesday. Let's hear a Satriani lick. Or air supply. It's a joke. I just told Tori about the prairie dog sucker, and she pretty much fell on the floor. The prairie dog sucker is a machine that they remove prairie dogs with, and it's got a big vacuum, and they just connect the vacuum to the prairie dog hole, and thump.
Just vision of a prairie dog going up to the vacuum tube.
Well, I wonder what's for dinner. Maybe some oats, maybe some... Whoa!
I gotta breathe.
Okay. It's a pretty funny concept, though, isn't it? What I was thinking, when I'm thinking remove prairie dogs, I don't think big vacuum, but someone did.
You don't ever think about that, do you?
All right, let's have a look. Here's Tug. Tug is a pretty dog. Hold on. We just thought this was funny watching old Tug do this. All right, now that he followed you up there, make sure you give him a piece of that sandwich, okay? Give him a piece. All right, whatever. Okay, yeah. No, don't. There you go. Tug's kind of a snatcher. Very pretty dog, though. Okay, let's go.
And this is my fish. Well, actually, the second fish I've caught with my fish trap, which Mom said would never work. So.
Oh, hi!
So, I gotta let him go in a second, though.
Tug says, I'll do seafood, too. No problem. Hence the name Tugboat. Now we'll let Tori do one. Tori does the next one. Okay, you ready?
Hold on. I got the camera. Oh, wait, we have the lens cap up. Get closer to Tuggy, I can't see you. I'm trying to get Tori in the picture. Just Tori, but never mind.
Tug shows indications that he could do this all day. dog's pretty strong.
Sister and I do actually kind of like certain aspects of her. We were looking at Mom's Kiss Me Curls. Look at those. Those are awesome.
Now they're kiss being me! Poked by my children. I'm yeah, hoping not to lose an that. Eye in the process. Keep wondering if we've dropped more pieces on the floor, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, look how the puzzle's coming together.
Ha ha ha. It's not a...
Hey, Alex did the blue part here.
Well, Tori did a ton of it, and then I did part of it, and then Lex made all the finishing parts. She did great.
Tori just gave us a look.
This green part is hard.
Why'd you put
yeah,
them,
this is
why'd
truly,
you take them out of the piles?
This, folks, is truly hard.
I didn't
puzzle.
Know that they were in specific piles. You didn't label them.
Because it's just kind of a...
It's hard
it's
to
worse
reach out.
Than a uniform color like that, because you really can't even look at the sheep shapes of the... Or the sheeps.
The sheeps, yeah, and right. The sheeps are real thin. Then yeah. The sheep hits the fan, and it's yeah. A disaster after that.
It's really
help,
bad.
Please.
All right.
This is called the videotape. You don't show me.
Well, we're out of here today. August 5th.
You see a pattern developing there, Victoria?
I'm trying.
My grandfather and I used to play a game with his cat somewhat like this.
How do you play it?
Well, the cat would be up there, and he'd toss the ball, and the cat would bat the ball back down.
Put it right there on the door sill.
Okay. I'm trying! Oh my god, there's two of them now!
They're right there. It's almost on the road. Come on!
Interesting. Interesting.
Don't hit the llama, please.
Oh, okay, sorry.
Oh my god, look at the size of that ostrich.
Llama crossing. Yeah, there's... We're gonna go
llama,
see Big...
Attention, llama crossing!
Big Daddy up there.
Hold on, hold on. I want to picture the llama. But I can't because the car's moving. Okay.
Why did the llama cross the road?
That's a good idea.
This old boy's big. See if we can get him to approach the bench here.
Judge would like you to approach the bench. I don't think Fred's going
to... Yeah, Tori's getting all ready here to...
Mom, I think the battery is running out. Or maybe we need to...
Hey, Mom! Mom, look at this! Look at this! I can't sit like this, Dad.
Hey. How about those guys out there? What's new?
What's new? Mom, isn't that cool? I put him.
Thank you.
You know what unbuttoned 3 buttons on my shirt when it did that?
Well, it must be a boy zebra. This zebra just snagged the whole bag of food.
This is what's left of the paper bag that, wait, let me see, that was this size. He ate the rest of it.
I am so sorry.
Reached in and grabbed it out of the car. Pretty fun stuff.
Oh my gosh. You've heard of me before, haven't you?
Move up, Dad, move up. Tori! I'm sorry.
I want the whole bag.
It sucks. You can bend their noses.
Yeah, see? Hi, zebra.
Whoa.
And just remember, if you hear hoofbeats, don't expect me. No, 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 get him going. Go. This is something feral with something funny and something fat.
Ow! That was me, Daddy.
What is he doing? Hey, hey, hey. Grab his little pity paw. That will elicit a reaction. Come on.
What's the point here? What to do? He doesn't care about his tail.
Let's grab that front toe. Grab a toe. Yes, Boots finally discovers you two deserve each other. Oh, that's is that his back foot?
Yes.
Does he even realize it's there?
I think so. He just doesn't use it very much.
We consider the back leg a vestigial organ. Okay, say bye-bye, you two.
Did you see the vacant look?
Vacant look? Yeah, I see it every day. That's pretty much what he is. Hi. Hey, you. Standing guard. Knowing someday his time may come. Hey, but look at the yard. Look at the yard. Oh, they're flying strands. And they're doing what they're supposed to be doing. Someday you will be mine. All mine. Okay. Oh, there's one playing girl. One playing girl next to one goofy dog. That's another one. She's climbing. Where is she climbing to? Holy smokes. What's up here? No!
I'm scared of heights, but I did it.
She did it. Can you believe this? You know,
I'm very proud of me.
I'm going to go out on a limb here.
Boots is in his regular position.
I know, standing
waiting for
guard.
The back door neighbor's dog.
Hey.
I have a headache.
She's got a hand headache.
Where mom is though. She's like, no, go down. Hey, can we get the rope up
there? A little further out. Woo! You can see how she is up there.
This is a good treat.
Are you videotaping me?
No.
Now the real question is, how the heck am I going to get down?
Well, I know one way.
Well, I know one way too, but I'm hoping to avoid that particular manner.
Doesn't even require much work.
Nope. Yeah, but then there are those pesky hospital bills.
Pesky. Hi. It's the Olympics, 2004. And I just thought, such a cute domestic scene. Tori's got a bad headache. And when you have a bad headache, nothing works like the mom scritchy scratchies on the head. That would be the volleyball.
I'm actually smart enough to figure out that it's volleyball.
Okay, that was funny.
See? It's a thumbs up.
Wait, it shows all the pictures here. Hold on a second.
Barney, gone bad.
Let me see, Mom. Yes, please. It's a baseball cap, Mom.
You're right.
Hey, Daddy, we found him.
Oh, we got the cookie cutters out. They're not deep enough, really. But I might could make do. Ooh.
Oh.
Yeah, but I found it's easier to make the sandwich and then cut it.
And when the headache gets really bad, you've got to burrow into Mom. Mom just said it's a warm one, but her artificial breeze is working very well. And we're out here to have a look at the swing. Well, the thing is, Alex seems to like only semi-permanent stuff because she wants to keep changing things around. Yeah. And have a look at the backyard out here. Looks nice, huh? We have actual grass. I'm filming. Okay, go ahead. What are we here to do? Oh, woo-hoo-hoo.
Look at that little go.
Round and round the noodle go round.
Anybody gonna climb
up goes the whiner. Much better.
Well, can't be good for
it. It was foggy. Here, go out there and interact again.
Yeah, but you should put it with the glasses cleaning stuff. What in the world are there bits of orange in the bed?
Whoa. How on earth did those get there?
It's over there.
Daddy.
Would that technically be considered littering?
Yes.
Oh, look at this. This clown does this minutes and minutes a day. He just grazes.
He's like the
like
sheep
some kind of funky sheep.
I'm watching.
And he's he's got this one doing it too. They graze.
Yeah, you know, Naughty never grazed until Boots came along. It's hard to wear.
He's back there, I guess, where the grass is greener.
But it's not on the other side of the fence.
No, the dog is not there.
Just a pretty typical day of interaction here, folks.
Later that day.
Mom's paying bills, which explains the headache look. And these goofballs are...
But you know what? We finally have enough money in the bank.
Uh-oh.
Right now to pay all the business bills. And that's kind of nice. Is there trouble brewing?
Well, Alex just gave up.
What happened? Is she squirting her sister now?
Yes.
Do you see Tori's eyebrows going up and down?
Alex, I think, was nominally or ostensibly going after a bug and just...
It just happened to hit her sister.
Tori right in the face. Whammo. And now Tori's upset.
Why don't you tell them to go spray down any spider webs or bugs on the playset, since they're always worried about that, and that way Lex and Connor can play on there later today.
Okay, good idea.
And they can wash off that table with the scrubby brush.
Hey, goofballs.
Like,
hey, why don't you go... See if you can scrub spider webs off the playset over there.
Ow! We'll just hose them down.
Yeah.
Oh,
yay! Was he pretty good? Can you play that at all, Chrissy? It's two of them total. What's going on? Oh, no, she's upset. See?
The rat's happy.
I'd rather not have you capture the most... one of the worst days.
Why has it been a bad day?
Oh my gosh, this is one of the worst days of your life. You ought to be grateful.
Right, there were no bullets involved. Like many people over in Chechnya recently. Right. You got to gripe about it on your cell phone. Right. Okay. Tell me why it was bad.
People in Chechnya had terrorists. I have mom.
Ouch!
Boots.
Keep telling me.
Do you know what happened?
She's in puberty. She's
right.
In puberty.
Is she?
Don't kill her. She better be. The rat still likes me.
Oh, let's see.
Well, she's awake now. The motorcycle that went past woke her up. Let's see. She's all snuggled in my arms.
Holy smokes, that is cute.
Her eyes are starting to close.
I never thought a rodent would be anything, but that one's that one's okay.
After the two or three mice that we had, remember I made the no rodent rule, but and then of course that stuck. How long?
The no rodent rule.
And
they tried to enact that in several of the courthouses across the country, and
those
just
damn lawyers kept coming
just
around.
Never worked. What do you think, Boots? Boots? Hey, Boots, wake up.
But Naughty's been nose to nose with her twice today.
saying, if you were only alone. 5 seconds is all I'd need, honey.
It was only Mom would only let me eat. You hear you sniffling at her again. See?
Well, because, of course, it's furry and it's dog toy-like. And it even makes little squeaky sounds when you bite it.
Well, once.
No, yeah, a couple of times.
No, I think with the German Shepherd, that'd be precisely once.
Once, yeah, okay. All right, well, what is today? The 8th, right? 8th of September, 2004. Is that right?
Yes, I went to my first Rice Women's Faculty Club.
Yeah?
Now, I knew that it was open to female faculty, wives of faculty, and wives of postdoctoral students.
Okay.
But I sort of, given the name, expected to maybe meet other women faculty.
You bet.
I didn't meet a single faculty member. They were all wives. And even better, the talk was on the politicization of science, which is fine in and of itself. And I understand that it's an election year and things have, you know, there's going to be a political spin on things, but oh my gosh, he got in at least 6 swipes at the conservatives, at conservative religious people, at the pro-life movement.
Who was this?
The speaker, who's the wife of one of the ladies. And well, I think he has.
Did anyone get a chance to like stand up and say you're full of crap?
No, they all agreed with him, honey.
Yeah, that's right. Okay.
Like he. Oh, so I.
So you didn't jump up and light into him?
It's the first time I'm there. I'm in someone
else's. Next year you will, though.
No, I probably won't be a member by next year. I'll give it 1 or 2 more meetings. And the president of Rice doesn't live in Cohen House anymore. Are you listening?
I am.
O'Connor House, rather. You know when you pull onto Sunset from Maine, the very first house in Sunnyside?
Yes.
I didn't know Rice apparently has owned that house for years and years and years.
No kidding.
And so it finally got redone,
mm-hmm.
And now that's the Rice president's house. Oh my gosh, it is huge. Definitely made for entertaining. Very nice place.
Say bye-bye, folks.
Bye-bye,
say
folks.
Say goodnight. Say goodnight. Say goodnight to the Tori of 20 years from now. Hey, what's going on tonight? It's September 10th.
I have a question. Is your skirt supposed to have these on the sides or one in the front and one in the back?
It's Tori's first dance.
I don't think I have it on.
At the YMCA.
All I'm saying is that you've got a point here and a point.
Say bye-bye. Okay, so what is it we're laughing about
okay.
here?
Okay, Tori's totally freaked out because Lexi took a cardboard box.
Tori's 11.
Tori's 11, Lexi's 7, and Lexi's best friend Connor, who's also 7, is here.
Right, right.
She took all the fabric out of Tori's box and put a lizard in it, and Tori went, well, okay, just don't get it wet. So she comes home from going to get a new binder with her grandfather because hers broke.
Right.
And they had made an entire habitat in there completely resident snails, as well
and
as the lizard in question.
And the box said, by the way, don't touch that one. The box, right?
So now Tori is very irate, and she just stormed out of the house. After griping for the last 15 minutes about how the lizard was dying, she realized she hadn't put the lizard back out yet, so she screamed. Oops, the nuts. Hey, baby.
Saying.
Yeah?
Sister, empties your fabric box of all of its contents. Then she makes it completely wet, and then she puts snails and lizards in it, and she doesn't even mean it when she says sorry.
I get a little annoyed. It was plural snails, but there was only the one lizard that I know of. That doesn't help much, does it?
Dad, turn it off.
Turn what off?
Basically, but then your sister puts wet snails and lizards in it. Honey!
Listen to me, please! Dad, turn it off!
It is off. I'm just trying to figure out what the heck I did wrong here.
Many things!
What's going on here?
Dad, turn it off.
Can you open the door for the little munchkin?
Knock, knock. Oh, Boots is knocking. Hey, got any bacon?
He's amusing himself, dear.
She does that, and you guys don't even care if
Connor's gone, she and I are going to have a talk about it. But I'm not, just like I don't embarrass you in front of your friends any more than absolutely necessary.
I'm Dad, turn it off. I know it's on that mini screen.
Okay. Well, what is today?
The not complete September 14th.
It's September 14th?
Terribly well aware of the date.
Okay, say bye, Tori.
Ah! Turn it off!
I'm your sister.
Alice is going to introduce Tori as her hero.
videotape. Videotape recorder. And as it's, we leave it out here for hours and hours. And, you know, I mean, it takes so slow, but if you speed it up, you see.
Let me see if I can night shot you here. Yeah, there. Now we can see you. Okay, that's weird.
Go away, Alex.
We're outside. The girls just had to come outside. To look. Okay, here we go. Back off.
Stop.
They wanted to see that moon up there.
Let me see. It's good to be buddies.
I described it as a...
You gotta come over here to see
it's
it.
Not a full moon, but it's, yeah, maybe I've got room for dessert, and then we leave the restaurant moon.
Okay. Oh, hold on. Lexi, stop it. Look!
Where? We saw it. Look. Oh, my, no, it's got to focus on it. Okay, there we go. And that's not a full moon. That's a full light. And this is our street.
Yes, and it's fun to hit Dad.
And this is Alex.
Also known as Insane Child.
I'm going to get you!
Zoom. Oi. Oh, look who joins us. Hark! Who cometh?
No!
It's the mom lady. Nighttime at the Brooks residence. Our little section of cul-de-sac.
Right there. I got another about a half a yard bag of stuff.
Most impressive.
Oi,
look at that.
That is going in the garbage.
Yay. Can you read this out here?
Nope.
It's pretty dark. So here's what it's like if I turn off this night shot. It's about like that.
You missed!
Whoa! All right, folks. Say goodnight. No, I described it as...
Now, we need the class.
Hello, what is it that we need? Did you say, what was that word you just
proper
used?
Proper fulcrum.
We need proper fulcrum for this.
Hey, Tori.
Yeah. Why don't you get something?
Leave it, it's okay. It's fine right now, Mom.
Why don't you get, like, a pine cone?
Now we need vinegar.
Put it under there. So
what are we going to do with vinegar?
You'll see. This is showing that air is a liquid. Well, you know what I mean.
Well,
it pours. Just like...
Right. Understood.
So
okay,
we have
good.
To find vinegar. Regular vinegar.
Oh.
Doesn't matter.
Go down low. Go down low.
Ow, Alex, stop it.
It's okay, I'm fine.
Down lower. Maybe right there behind you. There's vinegar.
That's red wine vinegar and balsamic.
Well, what kind of vinegar do we need?
I need Lexi to go take this and
here
throw
it
in the garbage bag over there. Look, stuff that's
Mom,
been thrown.
Stuff, you know the vinegar and baking soda? Is this the stuff that will work
yes.
with it?
Yes, that's vinegar.
Okay. Baking soda?
Where do I put it?
In that big garbage bag that's in the study.
Thank you so much, Princess.
Now we need, like, a pitcher. Where's that big pitcher we have?
Should be down there.
Okay. I'm going to be very careful.
Is it the last one?
Because he's opened a bunch of retail shops.
Okay, get the dogs out here. Let's see. That's your
dog. Okay, now,
if this works, Mom, I need you to come over here so you can see it, what it does. This is like...
I have no idea what's going to happen here.
I'm a little afraid, personally.
We've got two bags on, you know, astriding a fulcrum, which
this
is surely about to fall off.
I wasn't concerned, dear.
We got some baking soda.
At the grocery store next
time. This is a dry run, folks. We have not done this before.
Bum, bum, bum.
Okay, now help me if it fizzles up. Now hold on. Watch.
Holy cow.
Oh, shoot.
No, well, that's a paper bag.
I know that. That's the way it's. Yeah. That's why I needed a bigger picture for it to work. And now come around.
What are we doing?
Well, I'm not really clear. No, guys, don't bump it.
Don't bump it.
Not bumping. Can I come over here? It looks like Sprite.
Okay, what are we doing?
I can't go past you.
Never mind. We need a bigger picture.
It's really cool.
I was just telling Tori how great it is that she's doing stuff like this on a Saturday night rather than doing Game Boy or,
watch her do this.
You know, smoking pot or whatever it is that
girls
do these days.
Okay, somebody's obviously
had
one beer too many.
No,
shut up.
You know what I mean.
Don't
I'm being goofy, but...
Okay. Hold on. Mom, stand right here so you can see if it tips. See, it's supposed... If I pour it... Not there! I'm trying... That's why I messed up, because it went too high for this.
Is anybody clean?
Okay, gotta pick it back up. Come on, let's go.
Dust it off and start all over again?
Meanwhile, Sphinx-like in the background is our meatloaf pet, watching quietly.
Are you baking something, honey?
Yeah. Open it up.
Ooh, cornbread!
It's hot!
Did you put sugar on
it? It's hot!
No.
Stop.
What was that sound?
Okay, hold on. Lexi, scoodle.
It's gonna be.
Okay, Lexi, stop.
Did you tell Lexi to scoodle?
Whoa!
Cow, what is going on there? Look at that.
Well, she's trying to pour the gas, not the liquid, I guess.
Oh!
It is going up. It is higher.
This is higher.
Yeah. No, it isn't.
So she's pouring
carbon. I just poured it into the gas, Mom. But that one's
right.
I'm sorry. You were pouring carbon dioxide in there. Is that what's going on?
Yes, this was released.
Because the carbon dioxide is heavier than the air. But why would it lift the fulcrum?
Why would it? No. The reason it would lift this is because when the gas is pouring into it, this goes higher. But I think that's why I said I need a different fulcrum. Because look, this isn't straight. This is slanted, so it's kind of
holding it up. Okay. All right. Let's work on that.
That's okay.
Onto the gas.
But it does pour, and if you had seen the experiment, it's really cool.
Oh, Tori, can I say you're doing?
I just said I'm filming both of you goofballs. That's Connor.
Wait to the camera, he's
Connor
gonna juggle for you.
Lexi's like best buddy. And that's Miss Jenny.
Excuse me.
What else?
Excuse your butt. Thank you. My child's backpack is in your car.
My car?
I hope. I'm in big trouble. We can't find shoes, backpack, nothing.
Maybe in Mr. Richard's car.
But he can't even ride in his car, did he?
Yeah.
Wimberley House, October 8th. Probably the final time we're here. There, down at the creek. Jerry's found a turtle. Excellent.
That's a pretty significant looking turtle there. Look. Sticking his little hands out. I'm going to
put him back in his house.
Yeah, what do you think he's going to tell his friends? Officer, I was all alone, and then there was lights in the sky.
And a big green guy.
Hold on.
He was kicking his back
out there. Mom? Right now.
Oh boy, water. Oh.
Hey, Rob. Not that way.
No tugging. Here, let me see if I can get him to come out of his shell.
Tell you, it's a turtle. Don't eat it.
See, look, look, look. You can see him. See? Did you zoom in?
Hi, folks. Don't mind me. Couldn't resist. Alright, be right back. We'll get the still camera charged briefly.
They've just discovered that the ducks are out there this morning. Maybe we can see them from here. Yes, there they are. Well, it's prototypically beautiful out here. Like always. And you know what's funny about us? This family has certain fatalistically stupid instincts.
And dogs can tell that we're big suckers.
And dogs are some of them. And
this
dogs can tell that we're... This dog has sort of started coming over to our house and hanging out with us. At first, this little female dog was kind of, what's the word, pugilistic? No. She was
pesty!
No, clawing the crap out of Alex and Tori. That's what the dog was doing. But now she's coming over and she's saying, and the first thing is she knows who the mommy is. So look who she just, boom, right down into Jerry's lap, which is a scream. And then she's just been, I'm a sweetie, take me home.
No nipping.
And the ironic and perhaps stupid thing is, the craziest thing is, we're actually considering
it. She's stealing Lexi's shoe and laughing at Lex.
Now, dear watcher, you have seen us do this same mobilization with Mike, talking about how stupid and silly we are. And here we are with this one. Of course, this one is a lot prettier. And this is a female. And that means Naughty and Boots would be okay with a female.
And she was chewing on Tori's toes.
There'd be a dominance fight.
Well, they're very nice toes.
There'd be a dominance fight, but that one's pretty much already settled between Naughty and Boots. But this is a darn pretty dog. You should see this girl's eyes. Hey, come here. Let's look at your eyes.
Look at
the eyes. See them? They're gold. Very, very cool.
But we need to figure out if she belongs to someone.
Well, I would go two doors down and just knock on the door and say, you want to give this creature away? I'll guarantee you they would.
So the difference is, Mike, we didn't have a chance to spend that much time with him before we made a decision.
Hey, Dad, can I hold the video camera?
Well, here, go ahead. I'm kind of holding it already. It's recording.
And then here's Tori.
Your grandchildren will see how goofy you were with the camera.
Oh, yeah. Hi to you.
Honey.
Now, where'd she go? Now, where'd she go?
Honey. Honey, come here.
Now, where'd she go?
There
she is.
Camera. Very, very
there she is.
Oh. Caterpillar
just fell off. Hi, guys. Hello. Hello. How you doing? Yeah, please don't chew on me.
There we are. Oh, yeah. See, she absolutely knows who's the mother. Yeah, and she just goes plop right on the mother. Mm-hmm. Yep. Where's the face? Where's the face? Oh, there it is.
My parents are gonna kill me.
Oh, look at the little face. Oh.
Okay, Alex. We probably need to shut that off. Everybody's on Alex time.
Oh, okay.
I like chubby
Whee.
Time.
Okay. Mom. Oh, back one. There we go. Mom, say bye.
Bye.
Our
bye.
Our erstwhile, bye. Or, well, for the time being, honey.
Bye.
Trying to
oh, by the way, this is.
Yes. History
the saga has continued to the second generation.
And
they're
solidifying the fact that, yeah, she is my daughter. Sorry, Tori, but you are mine.
Okay. Well, I'm just telling
girls,
far side
have y'all met these other girls?
Hello.
Hi.
This
Hello.
One is Drollop from the planet Bleeb.
This is Drollop from the planet Bleeb.
I forgot.
Can't
you
get that straight?
This is Jaya and Brooke and Megan, my messy girls. We've had a
I thought
all
you only
weekend.
Had two.
These two. This is a friend, and we've had another one, but she just went home.
Guess
we've had
how
all
many years?
Nice.
Off to Jacob's plate, and what I do is I transfer it to the computer.
I know there's got to be a better way down than that.
Ooh. Very neat.
Hello, Biggles Nick Shiver. If you want to take girls who are wearing football, do you want to take them off?
Basically, this is the headwater for Cypress Creek, the creek at Mom's place.
Oh, please. Don't take pictures. I might fall in.
It's real slippery here.
Tori, you gotta go in, babe.
She has ice cold water tickling her brain right now from the inside. Everything. I just lost my shoe.
Shiver.
Okay, good job, folks. High power to weight ratio.
Shiver.
Oh my
gosh. I'm
gonna
get
into
water. We're just pulling away from Jacob's well, and we see probably the guy who tried to slam David's car coming back. He's saying, "I didn't get that car."
Maybe I can get his little brother instead. Hold on. Unfortunately, it's as close as I can get.
This is the road out of Jacob's Well here.
Well, it was really a precarious walk down, so we didn't bring the regular camera with us.
Did you zoom in, Mom?
I zoomed in as far as I can. I mean, I try when we get around this bend to
he's still there.
Get another picture.
It's a girl.
No, it's a boy's got antlers. Girls don't have antlers. You have to go a little further forward, Rob. About one more foot.
Oh,
darn. Wait, stop. Thank you.
watching. No.
Feels like it's the first real day of fall out here. Weather feels perfect. It's probably mid-70s, been a little windy. That's not stopping these blue falls from getting in the water though. Hey, how cold's the water? What's that? Okay, and here we have a little bit of a rock skipping derby. At least I think. Hey, Tori! Skip another rock! Excellent. See, that cross was given to us yesterday at the Mexican restaurant.
We always go here.
Country Bakery, to get our famous pigs. What do you think? Pigs?
No.
No?
Yes! No!
Wait, what?
Okay. Yeah.
Good evening, Agent Chu. You've been selected for this special mission. Please see Agent Subteach Hammonds, located at House Alien Gargoyle Roof at the end of our street. Please knock on her door, and Agent Hammonds will give you the mission folder in person. Good luck, and don't forget to turn off the TV and record.
Sketch of life.
A little after midnight, Tori wakes me
up. Who's 11 right now? She's 11.
To ask me a question. She's not sick. She's not upset. It's not critical. She had a question about soccer. Little after midnight, I'm dead, absolutely sound asleep, and she wakes me up, and I'm like, Tori, I was asleep. So she goes, oh, okay, never mind. So this morning, I brought this up to her, and I said, you know, I can't believe that. Well, Mom, I thought I was being really considerate because I said, never mind, I'll tell you later, I'll ask you later. I said, well, yes, that was more considerate than if you had continued, but it would have been, what would have been considered is not waking me up to begin with. And then she gets all upset with me because I'm like, Tori, I'm laughing about it. I think I'm being very reasonable given that I was sound asleep and you woke me up to ask me if I'd found anybody from the Kingwood soccer team to start looking at your play. And I said, think what would happen, you know, something like
that. Good thing she's not obsessive about that.
Yeah, I know. But she's like, well, I thought I was being really considerate because I was like, no, considerate is not waking me up to begin with. So like, well, I stopped and said, yes, but it's not like I immediately fell back asleep. God. Not the best one. I don't even know which kid it was who came in, about 3 years old, probably. Middle of the night, opens the door, Mommy, do spiders pee? which I replied, I don't know. Wait till the morning and ask Avi.
Okay. Sketches of life. Diwali, you call me back.
Why? That's the one you told me to order for you.
Yeah, but they're sending us, like, way too much coffee.
But that's the one you wanted, I thought. Okay. Just cancel.
She's doing open what surgery?
Open photograph surgery. Yeah. It's a lot more dangerous than it should.
Okay, what's going on here, Alex? Yeah.
And it was supposed to be a month late, and now it was 5 days late. And she looks just like me, only she's taller.
Here, close your mouth, just like she's got her mouth closed. Yeah, it's better resemblance there. Hold your eyebrows up a little higher.
Only if I had the outfit on, then she looked just like me, and the headband.
Good job, Alex. Okay. Well, I'm sure we'll be seeing more of her. What's her name? Lalex? We've got to have something. She's your twin, so it's you.
Alex.
You're Alejandra. That's got to be Jalejandra.
Alex.
Oh, Alex? Okay.
Well, the doll
name
is Alexandra.
Oh.
Alexandra.
Oh, excellent.
Can I call her Alex?
Well, I have a company name for Alexandra.
What about Allie? Allie.
No! Allie!
Allie, it's Allie.
Tori's doll named Tori,
but Lexi should be named after him. No, it doesn't have to be!
It's Allie, folks. That's just what happened right here.
You call her Alexandra, I call her Allie!
See, we're on video, so Mom's gonna be nice.
I can't!
Say bye.
Bye!
So what do you think of that? What happened tonight, babe?
Well, I'm just bummed because I know that was a great opening for a perfect personal slam, and I got nothing here. I do over notice there's a giant cockroach crawling across the fireplace.
You have got to be kidding me. Look at the size of this thing.
Okay, Brett needs to come over.
Yeah, it's time to get your boyfriend Brett here.
We broke up 2 or 3 months ago, you know that.
Okay, yeah, only after I told you to. Okay. Wendell's, and here's Wendell's, and look at Wendell's daughter. Look at this thing. This is amazing. Look how cute she is. I said there's a lot of Betty Davis here, and they got offended when I said that, but oh well.
Offended?
I don't know.
Offended. Not defended.
Listen to what Lana has to say.
Yeah.
Tell us, Lana.
Say hi. Say hi.
Hi, people.
Man, look, she's got great hair. She's as cute as she can be. And Wendell's looks like a triathlete. We really hate her because of that. We're really torqued off because of that, but oh well, whatever.
Hi.
Well, she comes over here, we'll fatten her up.
Lexi, you're show off.
Tori's been a little sick lately.
Tori was sick yesterday. Yeah, you'll get it to you.
Tell him. Say hi to the camera.
Hi.
Hey. Oh, you can do the Japanese.
Japanese?
Why don't you get it?
Oh, without.
Yeah, did you never want to
know? Yeah.
Yes, and I resent it. So many Japanese people.
Like, there you go. Do you hear that?
Oh my gosh. I'm going to get all my new pictures.
Come here. Tori's not feeling as well as she could. Alex, as usual, is in her spot. Boots is in his,
Well, he doesn't normally sleep there.
Initial spot. He's got his can of beans in front of him.
Oh, God help us all.
There's Nutty, wrapped with whatever Boots is doing. And here's all these clowns.
Hi.
Tori's not feeling very well tonight. What's going on, Tori?
What do you think? Do I look like I'm playing Candyland?
Tori's had bronchitis again for about 2 weeks, and her chest hurts, and she's feeling pretty
funny. Hello.
Hello. And she's starting to run a little bit of a fever, so it's some Robitussin and some help training down, rubbing her back.
The camera likes me.
Let's see what it looks like.
No, you like the camera.
See, that's what it is without the...
Hello.
Can't see.
You're only going to encourage him.
I can't see. I can't see.
All right, good night, folks. Then.
See.
All right. December 11th, 2004. Chris Brooks inventory. Initial look at the room.
Probably that's something that would have to go to the same person that looking at the story.
What's above here?
Storage. There is storage.
Make this?
Excuse me, Sherry.
I'm sorry, I'm in front of the sword. The way it's supposed to
well, I understand that. But still in the main office.
Maybe pull out the closet stuff and put it in the lobby.
Actually, I meant
others.
Okay, we're in the afternoon. Here's all the clothes that we found. All weapons and guns are in the van to take to safekeeping.
Like it's empty, but
here are in the you call this the maintenance room, Teresa?
Yeah, because he maintains the property.
Here's a large box of crystal, and there was an inventory on it. We're looking at the inventory right now, but it is full. Here is a lot of maintenance stuff. Typical piece?
It's never been used.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, the date on the paper is 1988, so.
What else was up there, sir?
Essentially stuff from, basic stuff from his old apartment.
Okay. And housewares and...
Yeah, just basic stuff.
Okay.
Mr. Penny reminds me of a long time ago, because he was into collecting all that junk with the horses and all.
Yeah.
And then that part of him was the surfing that he liked so much. Yeah.
Well, you know, you got the cars, but it's funny. It's just a surface kind of impression. He didn't really make. Well, I don't think he really wanted to make that big a take the place over kind of thing.
What the heck did that mean?
Well, it came from Robbie. We'll never really know.
Like the guy who goes driving on the beach and then goes makes real careful that his tracks are covered up after he leaves because he didn't want to disturb. You know what was there.
Okay, you're really not making any sense, sweetheart.
Okay, so everybody got their little things. It was funny, Jerry. How about Harry Day?
The insurance is paid. I'm right there with you. The insurance is paid up on this place.
Hey.
Hey, bad girl, bad girl.
Yeah, I get it. Okay, I'm a little slow on the uptake.
God. And worst thing, he's got it on tape, so
hey,
the place burns down.
But I'm not slow on the intake.
Shall we head to Mom's house? Because I have that ham, and we can make the corn casserole. Jerry has gotten really good at that.
I can dump and stir.
Yes.
You dread it.
In the best
casserole.
Way.
Okay.
And we can have salad.
Enough of Brooks's for you for a while.
Hey, you're welcome to come over.
Thank you. Still family.
Okay.
This is a story about CC Brooks.
From Teresa. From her, the owner of her company.
The owner of my company, Glenley, was telling me the story about how your dad, when he would come to the country club, or when they would come in from playing golf or playing cards, he would order a glass of water. Then take all the lemons that he could find, sugar packets, and make his own lemonade.
Because he wouldn't pay for the lemonade.
He would not pay for the lemonade.
That's dad. Not only that, but
that is so your father.
Both Mom and Dad, after every meal, everywhere we ever went in my whole lifetime, you know, would take all the sugar containers, all the butter containers, any leftover rolls, anything that was on the table that wasn't nailed down. That was Dad.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, and I love what in their bedroom at the old Brooks Manor, there were boxes and boxes of playing cards from the card room at Golf Crest. They'd use the deck of cards four or five times and then throw them out. He'd go fish them out of the garbage.
I remember that box full of playing cards.
Well, they would use them one time, actually. If you're part of the ladies' bridge, you know they just use them one time.
Oh,
it's just like the casinos, they only use them one time.
That's right. Because who knows what people could do?
Because they can be more
with their little hands.
I'd never thought.
Or even, you know, they mark it with sticky stuff.
People even less reputable than us.
We're here today on December 11th. We're conducting an inventory of Chris's estate.
Chris's office.
They're the ones that we can tell on the table.
We're in Chris's office.
And we're remembering Dad and Chris.
Yep.
We're
reminiscing a little, folks.
Remember the time we went out to dinner with your parents and your mom met, we were at Luby's because his father lived to go to Luby's.
Especially
and the Luann platter.
Ah, yes.
And your mom accidentally left the little carton with the leftovers out
of
the table.
Yes, it had a thigh of chicken and probably a little vegetable ort in it. Okay?
Vegetable ort.
Yes.
Explain to us
vegetable
ort.
Ort would be little scraplings of vegetable stuff.
Chris always took stuff, you know, wherever we went to eat. Mm-hmm. Well, my refrigerator is full of what I call Chris's bits and pieces.
I'm not that bad. What are you talking about?
He never checked the dates on
it.
Robert.
Bye, Robert.
Oh, my God, it's genetic.
Oh, it's awful.
Okay, yeah, sayonara. Yeah.
Bye.
I'm lots of people about that.
Salud.
And I'm always like, you know, I'm like, okay, it's out of date, throw it away.
What's going on here, folks?
Oh, don't put that on the floor, honey. That can crack.
Oh.
Put it on the table.
Hi, Mimi. What's going on?
Hi, Daddy. Hi.
We just kind of
did
a spell.
We
had
a good time. We knocked the floor.
Can you
get
them to do it at my house?
I taught them a better way, didn't I, Tori?
Yes.
Good. You can
do it at our house now.
No.
Yes,
see the...
No.
Let's see. Don't let this
get
us, man.
Video.
Smooth,
Dad.
Can I see the video?
Okay.
Thank you.
All right, let's go.
Okay.
No, Alex. Please don't knock that beautiful
watch
crystal vase over.
It is so beautiful.
No, Alex. Okay, hold on. First of all, don't do it here.
Okay, let's do the scare flick now.
All right, people, zoom in for a scare flick. Hold on.
Rolling and...
Now, hold on. Lex, you can't make any noise. I'm just going to stay very still. Wait, actually, you need to set this down. Hold on.
Yeah, you need to set it down. Okay, can it see the flowers?
Yeah, it's seeing the flowers. I'll cue you, okay? I'll go 3, 2, okay? Okay, you gotta do it right. Like, stay there. Go under.
Well, the party that they did was $20 a piece. The most expensive one is $30 a piece, or $35.
Hey, folks, it's December 12th. Alex, what's going on? Where did you go tonight?
I went to the Vizu's at Katie's birthday party.
About the girliest place you've seen.
It's very cool.
It's extraordinary girly.
It's a chick place.
Do the eyebrow thing when we ask, do you want to do your birthday party there?
Yes, I do.
And, I got my hair done, and I got an outfit on.
And her nails were done.
Mm-hmm.
And she got some neat party favors.
Okay, you're going to have to move the car. Okay, give it a try. Yeah, you're getting there.
If I can zoom in, I don't know how to use this thing. This is our flower arrangement, and this is my annoying sister, and this is the flower arrangement. See how much, see how much nicer it is? Okay, bye, folks.
It's peaceful time. Mama?
Why do I stop it? Mom? I mean, Dad? How do I stop this?
From Chris.
How did I stop this? How do I stop this?
Hit the red button.
Mom, we got cheese. What? Getting cheese.
Going here.
A Christmas tree?
Check back in a few minutes.
Do it. I promise I won't drop it, please.
No. We got snow.
Okay.
It's December 24th.
Down
I don't know if we'll be able to see the flakes here.
Yeah,
but...
come here,
you can see a little bit on the cover of the grill.
Oh, hey.
The last time it snowed, Tori was about 8 months old. So we're holding with that once a decade thing that we always do. Here, why don't you look at it? So you can prove it by looking at the.
Oh, if we look up. Look up. Over here.
Look at that.
Let's catch it.
Pretty happy about that, I think.
Let's see, you can see it on the grill. See? And we just called Aunt Gracie to make sure that they knew it was snowing so they could go
real
out
snow.
And see. Isn't that neat?
Well, I'm going to go call Mimi and tell her.
I like these sparkles especially.
Back, cough, Christmas morning.
I think there's something in your stocking too, actually.
Oh, let's have a look. Good morning.
Morning. Merry Christmas.
Good morning. Oh, is this mine?
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
Ah, who else would it be?
Oh, I hear crackling.
Look.
And we were getting a picture of this clown.
Maybe I was.
Slowly falling asleep. And
falling
off of the sofa.
While falling asleep.
Where's your husband?
He died 6 years ago.
As we can see now, this is the wild variety of snuff. So, we must be very careful, or he might fall on us. When he falls asleep, that is. Bootsie Wootsie! Oh! Okay, back to you, Dad.
Oh, thank you.
Please watch it.
Whose birthday is it?
What?
Say hello.
It's the big dog.
Happy birthday.
Eight.
Ah, he's got me.
I'm still clueless.
I'm really good at
putting
the
government
books.
No, I'm really good at
putting
the government
books. He's already done it.
Yeah!
Practice.
Don't do that, please.
We'll
need to.
We'll leave until the dogs come. And paper!
And paper!
Paper! And...
Now nothing.
They're
cool.
You have blue lips, child.
I know I do.
What else do you got?
Out.
Well, let's move the Barbie bag so we can... Can we move the Barbie bag so we can see other presents? Near anybody, okay?
Here we are at Noise Central.
Don't say your nails on fire.
I bought a new lighting thing so I won't burn any of my nails anymore.
Three, seven, eight.